First of all, I would like to little bit go in details why GGRC is needed. There were several schemes which was running before GGRC, which varying subsidy norms, so that the farmers were getting confused whether to go to which departments. So it was therefore considered by the government to pull all efforts into an integrated approach, so that the scheme is uniformly implemented in the entire state. So the GGRC has been formulated in the year 2005.
I would just like to add on over here at this point of time is that our country being a welfare state, we all know that agriculture sector is highly subsidized. Now it's a matter of providing an efficient, effective delivery mechanism. Now, today we all cry that the governance is, government is bad, the governance is bad. It's not really so. The governments are always good, the governance is bad, and that primarily comes out of the fact that perception of the government and the delivery mechanism that there are issues. And it's because of the delivery mechanism that all the problems in the field arise. To have an effective delivery mechanism, we need to have two things. One is a strong political will, and second, a strong public will. In fact, Andhra Pradesh and Gujarat, we should say, were fortunate enough to have strong chief ministers who themselves took keen interest and established institutions like APMIP and GGRC. And that itself speaks for the political will. Now, public will can be generated through transparency, nothing else but transparency. And transparency one can achieve through technology. Yes, please.
Formation of GGRC. GGRC has been renamed after the Governor Gujarat is carrying. It was already a government company with three big giant companies, that is GNFC Gujarat Narmada Valley Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited, GSFC Gujarat State Fertilizers and Chemicals Limited, and GIC, that is Gujarat Agro-Industries Company Limited. GABC is the company which was already existing with this as a joint venture of these three big giants, where Government of Gujarat intervened and it's renamed as Gujarat Green Revolution Company Limited with a scope to implement the micro-irrigation scheme in the entire state. Of course, we have vision and mission statements of these companies to achieve a sustainable natural resource management design in the agriculture sector in the state of Gujarat, whereas the mission is to promote concept of micro-irrigation among the farmers of the Gujarat as a tool for wise usage of resource resulting in a higher agricultural productivity, thus improving their livelihoods and empowering them to participate meaningfully in the agriculture sector in the entire state. Whereas for GGRC, it was for an implementing agency for us, it is a state of our technology usage to process the micro-irrigation scheme on behalf of Government of India as well as Government of Gujarat. So this is the mandate on which we are working. So this is the GGRC is a centrally operated scheme at location at Baroda, wherein we have developed certain software so that we can monitor the entire applications. Farmer will have to, we all are very aware that we are living in a computer age. So we have developed a software from the applications to the final payment, trial installation of the system and final payment to the MI suppliers. The entire process has been done by the software, computer-based program. For example, we are issuing unique registration number to each MIS farmers who are installing migration scheme. Likewise, we have issued a unique code to each and every beneficiary farmers. Like VID is for Baroda district and unique serial number sequential code to farmers. For example, in this case it is 20,068. The name of the farmer and all the details has been feeding into this software, where they can generate this registration number after forwarding all the details. this is we are receiving MIS application or online address delivery. A document verification has been carried out by GGRC. Then MIS post and design verification has been carried out. We are estimating subsidies of the farmers. Then work order has been issued where farmer gets idea of his contribution. After issuance of work order, there is an agreement between three parties. That is, one is farmer because farmer is the end user. One is MIS supplier because suppliers have a guarantee of their components, and GGRC. So after signing of this tri-party agreement, we are collecting the difference amount from the beneficiary farmers. Say in GGRC case, the farmer will have to pay 50% of his share out of the total MIS cost. So at the time of submission of tri-party agreement to GGRC, the farmer has to deposit their share. After which we are again releasing 25% as an advance to beneficiary farmers who wants to install the pre-post irrigation system on his field. So after the receipt of after the releasing advance payment, suppliers are delivering their MIS components on farmers' field where they are carrying out installation of all the activities, which is again verified by third party inspection agencies recruited by GGRC. After inspection, satisfactory inspection report of material verification as well as successful trial of the micro-irrigation system, we are releasing the final payment to MIS suppliers. So this is the entire procedure. Now, since GGRC has been started, so this is our coverage. What are the success factors of this GGRC model? It is a single nodal ends in the entire states implementing their micro-irrigation system. Highest level of priority of the scheme. Water resource crunch. Acceptability of for MIS adoption. There is a high level of acceptability among the farmers due to the benefits for this thing. Induction effect and motivation between increasing crop yield. Robust key implementation system, corporate style of functioning with quick decision making authority. Subsidy norm is 50% of the total MIS cost of Rs 60,000 per hectare, whichever is less. Ceiling is higher compared to other states. Taking systematic approach by delivering MIS to the farmers. Quick and centralized application processing at GGRC through software. Flexibility, farmer can select system and MIS supplier of his choice, crops and area as well as he can and system design as well as his requirement. Farmers are not being selected by any agencies. Farmer himself comes forwards to select his choice of his MIS suppliers. Transparency at every stage of MIS application processing, we are not dealing a single paisa of cash transactions. Online payment to MIS suppliers. No cash transactions. Stage-wise processing of MIS applications along with the financial transactions are accessible to all stakeholders through company's website. We have also a transparent MIS component price revision mechanism based on the changes in the price of crude oil. We are changing the raw material prices and accordingly the component prices.
Yes,
now the monitoring is also important for the any kind of schemes where multi-stage monitoring and control system has been there, where site inspection through third party inspection agencies, compulsory 100% site inspection of physical as well as trial of the MIS system, inbuilt software to track duplicate cases, application of easy geo capture which is carried out by a smartphone along with the GPS coordinates that will be seen later on in detail. Factory site inspection of for ensuring manufacturing capability and quality of MIS components as per PIS norms, Bureau of Indian Standard norms, through three agencies, CPET, Gary, and Data. Now, what is easy geo capture? Is an application that it is an application that is a mobile based application which along with the that image which is captured by the mobile phone, that with the GPS coordinates on an Android platform. The image that is being captured is geotagged and encrypted, and then user is provided with the facility to upload that image to the GGRC server. So how it works, that we will see. So suppose this is a screen and this is the mobile phone where the inspector appointed by third party inspection agency takes the photographs of the system installed. This is the latitude and longitude of that particular village, that particular case,
very site, that particular site, that point.
That point,
very after that can be overlaid on a Google map.
Yes,
that's simple as that. So this is what is happening today as far as people, as far as inspection of each and every site is concerned. And that leads us to a lot of things. So now next, what we are going to do is we are taking this a step ahead and trying to work out an inspection which will be paperless. Now over there it will be a tablet based application wherein the base data of that particular inspection site would be downloaded into the tab. The inspector has to fill in the tab, take the thumb impression and the signature on the tab itself, take a photograph, walk on the main line and the sub main lines so that their GPS coordinates are noted, and we have a map. We ask the MIS suppliers also to upload a CAD map, which they are otherwise also doing it. And now this gets overlaid on that original map so as to verify. So when your question initially, you remember you are asking, that is the possibly answer, that if there was a issue which came up, that there were a lot of designing, Somnath was mentioning, that the design is different and the implementation is different. So possibly this could be one way of using technology to get an updated situation from the field.
How it works?
This is what it will work.
Just go ahead.
Just run through. Run through. Run
through.
Just run through. Run through. This will be all well. Yes. Go back. Evaluation is extremely important. So we have Agricultural Finance Corporation doing the concurrent monitoring of the scheme. Socio-economic impacts are being assessed by NGOs. We commission NGOs to do that. And right now we have commissioned even Dexter, our consultancy, to carry out a 5-year evaluation. Support service is a very, very important issue in this whole thing. And we have an organization that is Roger Market Light. They are providing with a service at a nominal price wherein an SMS goes to the farmer giving certain basic information, that is weather. He gets a weather information, that is maximum, minimum temperature, humidity, as well as rainfall predictions. Then he gets news or market price of two crops of his choice from two market of his choice. Every day he gets an SMS. So that empowers him. And apart from that, he gets messages pertaining to agriculture sector in his taluka or district. Maybe some scheme is out. Agriculture officer wishes to give something. Maybe some farmer has done some good work. University has got some good results. So the contact number of the contact person is passed on to the farmer. So right now, every beneficiary whosoever is participating with GGRC, every drip beneficiary is entitled for this service. So he gets it. So, and we have input is one thing we are venturing into, so it's still new. Awareness is, yes, we do a lot of awareness and participate in all government programs. We have a strong complaint redressal cell, the trophy inquiry advisory service. I just wish to mention that so far we have covered about more than 5 lakh hectares. You have seen the data. There are 325,000 farmers who are enrolled with us. But our complaint kind of thing that we find is just about 0.3%. So that itself, now if we go to the success, and now if I can sum up this whole thing together.